ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for this invitation. You know, I've been hearing so many views on multilateralism, the death of multilateralism. I thought from a trade perspective, I should certainly not agree with it, because especially when I look at the WTO. You know, I was reminded of Mark Twain, who said that the accounts of my death have been highly exaggerated. Especially when you look at it from the point of view of WTO, what's happening in the WTO. So I don't think that multilateralism per se is dying there. I think what's really happening there is there's a lack of dynamism among countries to change the way that you deal with at a multilateral level. And I think that's it, especially what we're seeing at the WTO, and I think that's where the problem is coming from. Because countries are used to leadership and some countries are used to following, now there is that whole equation is changing. And when we see those equations changing, I think what's happening is people think that multilateralism is dying at the WTO. But I would tend to differ there, and I have a few views on why that's happening. First of all, I think I would agree with a lot of speakers who said that multilateralism per se has never had a smooth ride. You know, even when you look at the WTO, it's been very cyclical. You know, when you look at sometimes we have had, you know, certain the ministerial meetings which have been a success, but a majority of them have not been. But whenever there has been a need, countries have come together, they have put together some kind of an agreement, and then they have moved ahead. What's happened, I think, over a period of time, and as I said that a little while back, is the fact that I think there are new leaders who are emerging there. And I think countries are not taking note of the new leadership positions that are coming. For instance, when we were at Argentina, the ministerial meeting in Argentina recently, it was very clear that, you know, while everybody kept talking about the US, the new leader is China. China is trying to drive the negotiations there. I mean, you know, if you look at even some of the bilateral negotiations that are happening, China is leading the way. When US moved out of the TPP, the Japanese led it because they don't want the Chinese to take control over the region. So we now have a TPP without the US. For the simple reason, the Japanese wanted to take control of at least one agreement in the region where China is not a member. I think that's one important thing which we have to realize, that there's been a change. I remember I was posted in Geneva as looking at Indian industry views there. And I remember that time I went to the Indian ambassador and I congratulated him when India was put on the top table of the G5. He said, "Viswanath, it's very nice to be on the top table as long as you're not the dish there." So, you know, the fact is that, you know, that there's no new G5 that's emerging. China is taking a lot of position. If you look at some of the plurilaterals that came up in Argentina, for instance, you know, we look at issues like e-commerce, MSME, investment facilitation, and issues like that. Interestingly, China didn't join the plurilateral outside the WTO on e-commerce, but we had Alibaba head coming there, signing an agreement with the WTO and the WEF to start an e-commerce work. And you know, when someone like Alibaba comes there and he does that, he certainly does that with the Chinese government, well aware of what's happening there. And they are one of the friends of e-commerce, but they still didn't become part of the e-commerce thing. So there is a new development there. India is taking a lot of leadership. So are a lot of other African countries who are taking leadership there. I would just talk about two or three other issues and then I'll stop there. One, I think what we are seeing in multilateralism, why multilateralism is under threat, as many people believe, is because there is this sudden huge surge in the bilaterals that's happening. And bilaterals that are making a difference to countries when it comes to trade, you know, because in a bilateral, you're not just looking at policy space, you're looking at market access. And when you're looking at market access, that since it's making a difference, people feel that, you know, multilateralism is under threat because bilaterals are doing so well, so why do we need multilateralism there? And that's the reason why, even within the WTO, and that's where the difference between how a developing country like India, or even Brazil or South Africa is looking at it, or some of the African countries are looking at it, and the US or the EU is looking at it, are the topics for discussion within the WTO. Earlier we had more larger general topics like agriculture, services, trade facilitation, and issues like that. But if you look at some of the issues that have emerged now, you're talking about e-commerce, you're talking about MSME, you're talking about investment facilitation. So we're talking about issues that impact business. And here again, I would take an example of a discussion I had once with the US ambassador to the WTO. When I was representing Indian industry, and when she told me that, "Sorry, Viswanath, but I don't have any kind of a clearance from my industry to go beyond this mandate." So I looked at her and I looked at her smile and I said, I suppose you made a mistake. I suppose you don't have clearance from your capital on this. And she said, no, you heard me right. I said, we haven't have clearance from our industry to go beyond this, on this particular issue. I immediately went back to an ambassador and said, I'd love to hear you say it once, that you don't have clearance from the industry to go beyond a particular mandate. And that's I think, the point why multilateralism is under stress at the WTO, if it is, is because countries like India look at the WTO for policy space. They look at how do we create greater policy. They believe it's a G2G platform, and it is not a B2G platform. While countries in the West, which is especially the countries like US, EU, and others, are looking at it not just as a G2G platform, but as a forum which will help improve market access to countries. And I think if you are able to change the way we're looking at the WTO and the multilateral forum, then certainly multilateralism will not die, or it would not go down the way it is we right now seeing it. Certainly the UN system is completely different, but here, especially in the treaty. A second thing, I think, which I think for the WTO to succeed, would be for countries to start taking a look at the positions all over. There is a growing protectionism, it's across the world. We had, just before Trump went to Davos, he talked about, imposing duties. India talked about how it's going to remove protectionism, came back and put duties again. We have done that across countries. We have seen that everybody talks about how they want to open up, but they've gone back home and talked about protectionism. So there is growing protectionism in this world, and I think that needs to be taken into account when we're negotiating at the WTO or at any trade platforms. I would end by saying I still don't believe that multilateralism is under threat. What is under threat is the old formula for multilateralism. I think what we need is a new formula for multilateralism at the trade level. I mean, I'm not talking about the other areas, I can only talk about trade. For the simple reason you said that NATO gave you a few gray hairs. So look at me, it's been over 2.5 decades. And Dr. Babu said he's written a book, so that's the reason why he also has one. Yes. So the fact is that, especially on trade, I don't think multilateralism is dying, but we need a completely new formula. Thank you so much.